I know Carl for 35 years, and I saw one of his early paintings, and I went, "This, I've never seen anything like it." And I kept, you know, when I could, buy paintings. I bought about 40, and then Larry David got turned on to it, and we became sort of patrons, right?
Mm-hmm.
We got a studio, and Carl was doing this, and but we always tried to figure out a way we could combine our brains, because he understood my head in a way that almost no one else did. And I understood his drawings. They were real jazzy, and so we had an idea. If I came up with thoughts, not jokes necessarily, but thoughts, that's just what would happen if he took it through his brain and made more of it. And that's what this book is.
Okay. So Richard, what was it like for you getting these images back? And is that you on the left in the picture?
I think so. At my age now, I've met a lot of people I never thought I would meet back in school, and an old rock group that did White as Shade of Pale, Procol Harum, the lyricist is Keith Reed, and I asked him once, I said, when you handed in your poems, the White as Shade of Pale, Salty Dog, whatever, if you're not familiar with them, they were a pretty great group, and really great, I loved them, and he said, you've written about 300 songs together, and when you handed the poem to Gary Brooker, who wrote the music, I said, were you ever disappointed? And he says, not once, whether it was a hard rock thing or a jazz, he didn't do much jazz, but really melodic. And I felt the same way. He never let me down. I was just shocked.
It was like being married, like a bigamist for 2 years. I never worked with someone so close, except my wife of 45 years, and we know each other really well. With Richard, it is a little bit different. He would call me up like 3 weeks after I did a drawing, and he'd say, is that a joint in the rabbit's hand? I mean, so everything kept, so we would laugh back and forth together, and then I'd beg him not to call me up. Because I said, I can't stop. I would, and Andrew would tell you, I'd walk around. I had little pieces of paper and matchbooks. I'd sit in a cafe. I couldn't think of anything else. I'd be making notes like I was studying for a Shakespeare play, something really important. So I had to finally stop him, and we stopped at 50. This could have been a 10,000-page book easily. It would have killed me and killed Richard, but it could have been.
Gutenberg would have committed suicide. I don't know. My nightmares have coming attractions. I sort of like that line. It's not a joke. If I said that on stage, like, you know, a club or Zanies, they would go, mm-hmm. Another whiskey? But combined with Carl's, you know, interpretation of the line, that's what makes this book, to me, I feel grandiose saying it, authentic, because it combines, it goes underneath the premise. And some of these aren't jokes, but it goes underneath how I really feel about life. Because a lot of people have said to me, why are you so depressed, man? You know, you've been living your dream 45 years, you're still doing it, you have this, you got a book, you got a new series coming out, blah, blah, blah. Why, you know, I said, hey, you know, having a new series has nothing to do with how I feel emotionally. I'm a recovered drug addict for 20 years. I still have that brain, you know. So he went deeper than some of these thoughts, and so it was quite revealing to me and profound in many ways for me personally.
So when I would do a piece, if I could put in an element that maybe nobody else will see, that reminded me of a part of Richard that either was present in the past or a new one now, the joy that he's in now, the happier ones are really happy because they wouldn't have been possible to do 25 years ago. So this was sort of, you know, the word, everybody says journey, but this truly was like a roller coaster journey, because I watched Richard from small clubs in the village to Jersey to Atlantic City to standing room only, standing up applause in Carnegie Hall. But I've also sat with him with Andrea 35 years having dinner in our apartment in restaurants with all the beautiful models, with all this and that. So we've seen the chapters of Richard. And these are done based on periods of time that we spent together.